Hello, and welcome again to the Harmonagon project. This subject assumes that you have watched our video on intervals. For this lesson, inversion is the process of reversing the order of notes in an interval by raising one of the notes by an octave. For example, if we begin with the major third, where C is the root and E is the major third, we can visualize the interval using the green line and arc. The line and arc color is green, in this case, to match the color of the root C. On the opposite side of the circle, a dark blue arc represents the inversion of the major third. When E is designated as the root and C is raised by one octave, the C major third inverts to an E minor sixth. The line and arc color also change to dark blue to match the color of the new root. You may swap intervals on the harmonagon so either assumes the top position. As you can see, both intervals, the C major third and the E minor sixth, use the same two notes. Only their order and function has changed. As a rule, major third intervals always invert to minor sixth intervals, and vice versa. In fact, all major intervals invert to minor intervals, and all minor intervals invert to major intervals. A major third is constructed of two whole steps, again represented here by the green line and arc. While the E minor sixth is constructed of four whole steps, shown here with the dark blue line and arc. Intervals and their inversions always add up to a perfect octave, 12 half steps or 6 whole steps, and make a complete circle. Let's make another interval. This time a minor third, where D is the root and F is the minor third. Here we can visualize this interval using the light blue line and arc. On the opposite side of the circle, a purple arc represents the inversion. When F is designated as the root and D is raised one octave, the minor third inverts to a major sixth. The harmonagon automatically inverts notes or raises the pitch by one octave when necessary. As before, you may swap intervals so either is placed on top. Again, as a rule, minor intervals always invert to the major interval on the opposite side of the circle, and vice versa. A minor third is constructed of one whole step plus one half step, as indicated by the light blue line and arc. While a major sixth is constructed of four whole steps plus one half step, shown with the purple line and arc. Again, intervals and their inversions always add up to a perfect octave and a complete circle. Let's make one more interval. This time a perfect fifth, where C is again the root and G is the perfect fifth. We can visualize this interval using the green line and arc. On the opposite side of the circle, a red arc represents the inversion. When G is designated as the root and C is raised one octave, the perfect fifth inverts to a perfect fourth. As a rule, perfect intervals always invert to the perfect interval on the opposite side of the circle, and vice versa. A perfect fifth is constructed of three whole steps plus one half step, indicated here by the green line and arc. While a perfect fourth is constructed of two whole steps plus one half step, shown with the red line and arc. Again, both intervals, the C perfect fifth and the G perfect fourth, use the same two notes, only the order and function has changed. The tritone, our special interval, always inverts to a tritone. Which is all it can do, since the tritone equally divides the circle, with the same quantity of steps on each side. Intervals and their inversions are like synonyms. The notes are always interchangeable, because harmonically they sound the same. Only the order of the notes and their function changes with inversions, as you can see and hear when we swap these tritones. So there, I recommend that you use the harmonagon to practice and memorize each interval and its inversion. Until next time, have a great day.